When you guys were on the Knicks together, I mean, did the Knicks think they had created the Ernie and Bernie show too? What didn't quite get there with you guys at the NBA level?
Together at the NBA level, I was a different type of athlete and player than he was in terms of being more of an elite player and an impactful player. And Ernie became more of a role player. But during that time that we had to play together here in New York City, we both lived the dream. Mm-hmm. He being from Forest Hill, he dreamed of playing for the Knicks. I dreamed of playing for the Knicks. And when you're a young kid in the playgrounds, you're trying to pretend you're Earl Monroe, not me. I couldn't spin like him. And you're trying to pretend you're Walt Frazier or Willis Reed. And my favorite at that time was Dave DeBuscher.
That's what I've heard. I want to add, I mean, you were, you know, as great of a scorer you weren't as great of a rebounder, which
I
is what Dave DeBuscher.
Oh,
okay, so that's
I led the conference in rebounding 3 years in a row in college at 13 rebounds a game, plus 25 points a game. That's pretty remarkable, and led it in field goal percentage as well. And in high school, I averaged 28 rebounds. So I was a great rebounder. And I preferred rebounding than scoring. That's why Dave DeBuscher was my favorite player. Dave was the new general manager for the New York Knicks when I left the Golden State Warriors, and I left as an all-pro, second team. And at that time, that means you're one of the two best, three best small forwards in the league. And he was the general manager that signed me to bring me back to New York, and dream fulfilled. And it was just a pleasure meeting him and talking to him. We didn't have chance to spend much time together because I was so busy doing my job and he was so busy doing his as well.
What was it, you talk about the thrill of actually being in New York. I mean, did you feel like you had made it back home? What was that whole experience like, just with these bright lights behind us, when you were actually the star of this city?
Well, I had played in, obviously, Madison Square Garden, playing for opposing teams, and it was always truly special. But this was an arena that was important to me, and it represented all of basketball to me and what basketball was all about. And every time I put on that uniform, it really meant so much to me. I had goosebumps every single night I put it on. I represented the legacy of the franchise, all those great players I mentioned, but I also represented the heart and soul of the city. I was one of them. And so I played my heart out for the fans here in New York. And every night I brought my A game, and I excel at the highest level. And it's beautiful because when I come back home here in New York, I reside in Atlanta, and they treat me like I was here just like yesterday, so it's quite special.